Classrooms are more diverse than ever. How can teachers effectively engage students from diverse backgrounds? This is a question that many teachers face. If you have been working in schools for a long time, you've seen the differences between students who were in your classroom years ago and students who are in your classroom today. When you stand before your students, do the faces looking back at you look like your own? Think about diversity in your classroom. How does it show itself? Take some time to reflect on these questions. Who are my students? What are their backgrounds and how many are from the same background as me? How might my students' traditions, values, beliefs, perceptions, and situations differ from my own? How do I identify this diversity? Is it visible?
This is a sales chart that we made on our total.
Classrooms are becoming increasingly multicultural, and this leads to new challenges for teachers. You need to be knowledgeable about how diverse students perceive the world, process and organize information. Culture and gender influence your values, beliefs, social interactions, and how we see the world, what we consider important, what we pay attention to, and how we learn and interpret information. Culture matters. Have you ever thought how your culture influences your students? Culture plays a huge part in education, in everything we do. Culture shapes what we teach, how we teach, and who we teach. So it is very important to recognize that culture is central to teaching and learning. It plays a key role in communicating and receiving information. A big challenge is that often students and teachers do not have the same cultural, ethnic, and social background. These cultural differences between teachers and students can create serious challenges to teaching and learning. Teachers use their own cultural filters to communicate instructional messages to students, and in many instances, these filters are not compatible with the students' cultural filters. A way to mediate these differences is to have teachers build bridges across cultural differences through culturally responsive teaching. To truly engage students effectively in the learning process, you must reach out to them in ways that are culturally responsive and appropriate. Geneva Gay defines culturally responsive teaching as a process of using cultural knowledge, prior experiences, and performance styles of diverse students to make learning more appropriate and effective for them. Culturally responsive teaching is a pedagogy that recognizes, values, and responds to different cultures. It offers full, equitable access to education for students from all cultures. It is important to remember that students are not blank slates. They bring into the class their cultural experiences. So culturally responsive teaching builds on students' prior cultural knowledge. Teachers take students' everyday lived cultural experiences and make the appropriate linkages between what the students know, do, and understand. Teachers make the connections. They are cultural bridge builders. A culturally responsive teacher has the knowledge, attitudes, and skills that give that person the ability to understand, communicate, and work effectively and successfully engage and teach students from different cultures.
Yeah, well, that is pretty cool.
How do we become culturally responsive? The first step to become a culturally responsive teacher is to understand your own culture and how it affects the way you relate to students. As teachers, we often believe that we can be objective and neutral, but we all bring our life experiences, cultures, values, and beliefs into the classroom. These assumptions are not necessarily bad, but when they manifest as hidden or implicit biases, they could have a negative impact on students. We all have implicit biases, which refer to attitudes or stereotypes that affect our understanding, actions, and decisions in an unconscious way. We need to understand and challenge our unconscious bias. This helps us to better understand ourselves and effectively communicate and work with students. Another key aspect of culturally responsive teaching is to create an inclusive learning environment, an environment in which students feel safe and allows them to be who they are, and where students feel that their contributions and perspectives are valued and respected. For this, it is important to establish a classroom tone that is caring, friendly, and supportive. Use teaching strategies that accommodate the needs of your students in terms of learning styles, abilities, backgrounds, and experiences. Analyzing the type of learning environment you're creating for your students is a great way to begin to create an inclusive learning environment. Consider some of these questions. Do my students feel empowered, capable of discussing concerns or challenges with me or others? How do my teaching practices foster a learning community where each student is valued and considered? What strategies do I use to support diverse learners? Whichever strategies you use to make your classroom more inclusive, remember to remain sensitive to and flexible about the ways diverse students think, behave, and communicate. This will help to create a supportive learning environment for all of them.